I'd say it's probably 9 feet. I don't think it's more. I've heard some people say 11, even 13.
There's rumors for you. This bowl looks really fun. However, at my age, my kids' age, and our abilities, this is something, if we want to continue to have fun here, we got to take it easy at first. This coping is not as great as the bowl I ride at Northeast Metro. It's really chunky coping. Here's looking in over the deep. If I was gonna drop in brushy or here, I think I might rather do it here. I don't know though. This is where I dropped in today. I only did it once. It does not look sketchy. And it's really not sketchy, but it was the first time. Hey Barry, whichever camera you're in, I dedicate this coping drop-in for you. I've never done this in my life, guys, but I'm not sketched. There's the oververt section. That spot where my kids are sitting is really tight and narrow. It's not something I want to roll into with speed. I think that's an eventual drop in and axle stall, maybe some slash grinds first. I like this little step here. I can see possibly one day doing a grind over that thing, however, a little sketchy. Let's go down the rolling. There's lots of cool stuff, like even that little section right there for somebody wanting to learn some 50-50 grinds in a round bowl. That's pretty sweet. My kids are probably gonna, they're probably gonna like that. Okay, so here's the back of the rolling. You can come around here, bank, go into some coping there if you wanted, or just take this rolling. It gives you a lot of options to get up on some walls, even on this side, up into the love seat. You could bank around the love seat. Like I said before, this was my very first slam, like the first day I came out skateboarding. I came out one night right after moving here. All my family was in bed across the way. I told my wife, let me go check this out. I wasn't sure I was gonna get up, except for there were like 30 kids standing around the top of this. And I said to myself, man up, you got to do this. Oh, great. And there's a condom right there. How disgusting is that? Not touching that thing. But anyway, look at this. This bowl has a lot of options, man. I mean, really, lots of stuff. It kind of feels like this wall in the deep end almost has some oververt pockets on it. It gets a little funky. I mean, it's way more smooth, I think, to do a really wide carving grind rather than some kind of a kick turn grind, because it does seem to be a little uneven up on the side of that, but I guess that's to be expected. This piece of coping right over here looks interesting. So I'm really happy that there's some concrete coping in my town that's sort of halfway aggressive as Brushy Creek. I probably talked to some of you guys that skate the Brushy Creek 69 bowl. You'll probably tell me, hey dude, it's a little more safe to grind over there, even though it's 9 feet high. It looks to me like this wall over here is at least 6 feet high, maybe a little more over there toward the edge. And this wall right here, 6 feet high or so. But honestly, I'm not doing an axle stall at Brushy Creek 9 feet for, it feels like quite a long time. Or maybe even get up into an axle stall right here. Yeah. So anyway, my thoughts about this place, it's definitely not a beginner's bowl in my mind, unless you're going to bottom dwell. It could be pretty gnarly, and it's much bigger than I remember. So anyway, peace out. We're catching some rain. We're going to be planning to do a session tonight as well. All right, man. Peace out.
Peace out.
Dun 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 dun. How's our song go? Mob battle?
Yeah.
Dun dun dun. I don't know. Do it.
I don't remember.
Look at her pants. She's a hippie chick today.
Hey, I'm not a chick.
I didn't like them at first, but now they're kind of cool. The bell bottoms, she's kind of rocking her own style there with those. All right, later.
Thank you, Jesus!